Hi, this is Julieta Yang Arfiano. Welcome to my video. If this is your first time on my channel, please like, share, and subscribe so I can notify you if I have a new video. This is the continuation of part 4 about the investments in equity securities and debt securities. I discuss in part 4 about disposal of available for sale securities. Just click above or the link below this video to watch part 4. In this video, I am going to discuss about the measurement and presentation in the statement of financial position available for sale securities. Measurement and presentation in the statement of financial position available for sale securities. Available for sale equity securities are presented as non-current assets on the statement of financial position are measured at fair market values. Any change in market value is recognized as other comprehensive income outside of profit or loss in the statement of comprehensive income. Illustration: assume that the following securities classified as available for sale securities were acquired during 2009 by ABC Corporation at the following purchase prices indicated, including transaction costs. Securities OPQ, number of shares 20,000, purchase price plus transaction cost 500,000 pesos. Securities RST, number of shares 10,000, purchase price plus transaction cost 300,000 pesos. Securities XYZ, number of shares 5,000, purchase price plus transaction cost 100,000 pesos. On December 31, 2009, the market values are as follows: OPQ 30 pesos, RST 28 pesos, and XYZ 25 pesos. The following shows the total costs, market values, and unrealized gains and losses as of December 31, 2009. Securities OPQ, total cost 500,000 pesos, total market 600,000 pesos, unrealized gains or losses 100,000 pesos. Securities RST, total cost 300,000 pesos, total market 280,000 pesos, unrealized gains or losses 20,000 pesos. Securities XYZ, total cost 100,000 pesos, total market 125,000 pesos, unrealized gains or losses 25,000 pesos. Total cost is 900,000 pesos. Total market is 1,005,000 pesos. Unrealized gains or losses 105,000 pesos. On December 31, 2009, journal entry to bring the available for sale securities to market is debit market adjustment available for sale securities 105,000 pesos. Credit net unrealized gains or losses on available for sale securities 105,000 pesos. The balance of market adjustment available for sale securities if debit is an addition to the balance of available for sale securities to arrive at the market value to be presented on the face of the statement of financial position. Any credit balance in the account is shown as a deduction from the ledger balance of available for sale securities to arrive at market. The cumulative balance of net unrealized gains or losses on available for sale securities is presented as part of shareholders' equity, an addition if credit balance, or a deduction if debit balance, forming part of other reserves. Alternatively, the balance of the available for sale securities may be adjusted to market through a direct debit or credit to that asset account, available for sale securities, without the need to use a market adjustment account. Disposal of available for sale securities. At the time of disposal of available for sale securities, the amount of realized gain or loss, which is the amount of gain or loss shown in profit or loss section of the statement of comprehensive income, is the difference between the net selling price and the recorded cost of the securities. The balance in both market adjustment and net unrealized gains and losses accounts pertaining to the security sold are eliminated. If the selling price exceeds the recorded cost of the available for sale securities, the entry would be debit cash, the net selling price, credit gain on sale of available for sale securities, credit available for sale securities at cost. If prior to the sale, the carrying value or the fair market value as the end of the last reporting period exceeds the cost, the entry for the elimination of the unrealized gain or loss is as follows. Debit net unrealized gains and or losses on AFS credit market adjustment, AFS securities. The two entries stated earlier may be combined to form one compound journal entry. In case an entity does not use a market adjustment account and the carrying value exceeds the original cost, the entry for the sale is modified as follows. Debit cash for the net selling price, debit net unrealized gains or losses on AFS credit available for sale securities at carrying value, credit gain on sale of available for sale securities, net selling price minus cost. To illustrate, use the same data for ABC Corporation's available for sale securities. Assume that in the year 2010, all of XYZ securities I sold for 130,000 pesos. Let us recall that the recorded cost of XYZ securities is 100,000 pesos and that their total market value on December 31, 2009 was 125,000 pesos. Thus, there is a related debit balance in the market adjustment account of 25,000 pesos. And a credit balance of 25,000 pesos in net unrealized gains or losses account. The realized gain that is recognized upon sale is computed as follows. Selling price for 130,000 pesos, cost of the security sold 100,000 pesos, gain on sale 30,000 pesos. The 25,000 pesos balance in both the market adjustment account and the net unrealized gains or losses account as a result of the latest valuation shall be removed from the books. Thus, the entry to record the sale compound form is debit cash for 130,000 pesos, debit unrealized gains or losses on AFS securities 25,000 pesos, credit available for sale securities XYZ 100,000 pesos, credit market adjustment AFS securities 25,000 pesos, credit gain on sale of available for sale securities 30,000 pesos. Further assume that the market values of the remaining securities on December 31st 2010 are as follows. OPQ 26 pesos, RST 27 pesos. The following table summarizes ABC Corporation's remaining securities on December 31st, 2010. Securities OPQ, initial amount recognized cost, 500,000 pesos. Total market, December 31, 2010, 520,000 pesos. Unrealized holding gains or losses, 20,000 pesos. Securities RSP, initial amount recognized at cost, 300,000 pesos. Total market, December 31, 2010, 270,000 pesos. Unrealized holding gains or losses, 30,000 pesos. Initial amount recognized at cost is 800,000 pesos. Total market, December 31, 2010, 790,000 pesos. Unrealized holding gains or losses, 10,000 pesos. At the end of 2010, before making any adjusting entry, the market adjustment account has a net credit balance of 10,000 pesos, debit of 20,000 pesos pertaining to OPQ, and credit of 30,000 pesos pertaining to RST. At the same date, the unrealized gains or losses account before adjustment has a net debit balance of 10,000 pesos. Cumulative holding gain of 20,000 pesos pertaining to OPQ and cumulative holding loss of 30,000 pesos pertaining to RST. The net adjustment to the market adjustment account is computed as follows. Required credit balance at December 31, 2010 is 10,000 pesos. Debit balance before adjustment, 80,000 pesos, which is 105,000 less 25,000. Required credit to adjust, 90,000 pesos. Similarly, the net adjustment to the net unrealized gains or losses account in the equity section is computed as follows. Required debit balance at December 31, 2010 is 10,000 pesos. Credit balance before adjustment, 80,000 pesos, which is 105,000 pesos less 25,000 pesos. Required debit to adjust, 90,000 pesos. The adjusting entry at December 31, 2010 is debit. Net unrealized gains or losses on AFS securities, 90,000 pesos, and credit market adjustment available for sale securities, 90,000 pesos, to adjust available for sale securities to current market values. Exemption to the rule on measurement at fair value. Available for sale equity securities without active market are measured after initial recognition at cost. IAS or PAS number 39, paragraph number 46, letter C. Thank you for watching my video. I hope you learned something from this video. I did part 6 and continuation of this video, wherein I discuss in part 6 about impairment of available for sale securities. Just click above or the link below this video to watch part 6. Don't forget to like, share, and subscribe on my channel so I can notify you if I have a new video. Once again, this is Julieta Yang Orfiano. See you on my next video.